Ahmadu Sadauna Amam Patigi was born in Kaduna on 7th September 1962 to the prestigious family of Alhaji Amam Patigi of blessed memory and Ajia Aisha Nagi. His father was a minister of health under Sir Ahmadu Bello administration. He also held the traditional title of Galadima Patigi. Sadauna Amam attended Central Primary School between 1968 and 1974 and had his secondary education at Patigi Secondary School between 1974 and 1979. After obtaining a national diploma at the Kaduna Polytechnic, he furthered his studies at the same institution with a higher national diploma in quantity survey and graduated in 1986.
We were born the same year. It's 3 months ahead of me. We started primary school at the same year. That was in 1967 at XIM Primary School here. Then we did primary 1, 2, 3 there. Our late father was appointed as the commissioner for Home Affairs and Information. And chairman, local government civil service commission. Then it moved us to Ukaruku Primary School in Ilorin. We did our common entrance there. We were the last set of primary 7. But we eventually got an admission to a Catholic school, secondary school. But as a good Muslim, and some of his malams that time advised him that he shouldn't take us to a Catholic school because we were still young. He has to bring us back to Patigi here again for another, we have to repeat that year at Patigi Central School here. After the next common entrance, we both got admission to Patigi Secondary School, which we both passed out in 1979.
After of fact, we were classmates at the prestigious Kaduna Polytechnic. We became friends since 1980. We were in the same class. We attended the same course, quantity survey, throughout the period of 6 years, R&D and
HND. Still in pursuit of knowledge, he went on to do a Master's of Business in Finance in 1995 at Oklahoma City University in the United States of America.
He went to Oklahoma, did his Master's at Oklahoma City University, and he came back. Actually, while he was there, was it after he came back, he was able to secure me, admission, and that's how I ended up as well, same school.
He worked with different organizations, including Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation, NNPC, National Electoral Commission, NEC, Nigerian Sugar Company Limited, NISUCO, BASITA, and the Securities and Exchange Commission, SEC. He was an associate member of Nigerian Institute of Management and member American Marketing Association.
When we look back, isn't it remarkable? Is it not remarkable that he achieved so much in the short time he spent with us on this earth? At that young age that he passed away, that he left us.
Like his father before him, Sadauna, as he was popularly called, decided that in order to make a positive difference in the society and in governance, one has to be part of the system. Thus, after consultations with family and other stakeholders, he returned home from the United States of America to join politics in 1999. He contested the senatorial seat under the platform of PDP.
His sojourn in politics was as a result of his determination to assist his people. He came from America, he was in my house, he said he was going to a contest. I said, contest? He said, yes. In my own capacity, I did all my best to support him. I was always taking him around, driving him during the campaign. And all his financial transactions for this campaign, he gave it to me. He kept it in my house. And he would be acting as if I'm loaning him. Look at the interesting thing about it. We never tell people, please, let's finish your hand. He called me, but I would take it.
He ventured into politics by following the footsteps of our late father and the person he was named after, the late Sir Ahmadu Bello Sadauna of Sokoto. While in politics, he practiced a grassroots democracy. He was a crowd puller, community mobilizer, and was loved by large supporters. He preached politics without bitterness, and he rose to become the state chairman of his party. We were pained by his loss. May his soul rest in peace. Amen.
He became the ADB coordinator. Then from there, he went down for his master's in America. Then after coming back from America, he was on his own for a year. Then later joined politics. He contested for Senate. He joined the National Party that time, which is PDP, that was at the national level.
This would launch his political career and make him one of the solid founders of PDP in Kwara State. The party was becoming a formidable force in the state. Ahmadu Sadauna became the PDP chairman, Kwara State chapter, in 2001.
He was a relatively young man, much younger than many of us in the party. But because of his personality, he was given leadership of the party by even those of us who were much older than him. He was a very amiable personality, very, very friendly. He was a handsome young man, and that made him charismatic. Now, because he was amiable, he was able to win the heart of most of the party members.
We have about 120 delegates that conducted the election for the three of them. The person from the south scored 30 of the votes. And Adi Musa Mayaki from Central scored 23. And he almost scored 77 votes. If you add this 28, it will give you 123. But two are not counted for because he made a mistake. That's why he became the PDP state chairman of Kwara State.
Sadauna believed that all human beings are created equally and should enjoy their God-given rights. That is why he would come across a child and want the child's rights to be respected and protected.
Like I already said, that's exactly Amu. He was just so kind-hearted. Like I said, he's ready to give you what it is that you want, and he's ready to take a back seat. That's the kind of person he is. It was at that moment that he inspired me, because his vision was to see how, if he could move all his family out of Nigeria, to give them, like the American dream, like the opportunity, and that was just him.
Throughout his political career, he has posed himself of high morality and intellectual virtues by respecting all stakeholders. These were qualities that the late Sir Ahmadu Bello imbibed as a lover of peace. He wished to end the violence that marred the political terrain in the state. He also tried to bring peace within the state party during his tenure as chairman.
During those struggle periods, he was a man of peace, seriously. He's a go-getter. and he loves people, especially young people around him. Whenever he wants to take a decision, it's going to be a collective decision that it will be well thought and well planned, and when it's being executed, you will see that at the end of the day, it's going to be fruitful.
Very honest, always full of life, and extremely brilliant. When you discuss with Ahmad, you know you are discussing with somebody who knows what he's saying, and who knows what he wants, and who knows what is good for the society. That is Ahmad for you.
Ahmad Patigi is this, was a straightforward somebody. Straightforward somebody. He doesn't discriminate. He favors everybody.
This, unfortunately, was cut short when he was assassinated. Again, like his namesake, he was gunned down in his prime while rendering his service to the state and the nation at large.
He just called on me one day that I should come down to the lorry. I went and meet him. He said, "Ah, brother, you are a bit late. I just have a phone call from Lagos now, from General Olusegun Obasanjo, then the president of Nigeria. Then on his way going, that was how before sudden news just come of his death. He was assassinated. Is it high killers? Is it armed robbers? No one can say. But everything is in the hand of God.
I think he got consumed by the politics of Kwara that state. There's no question about it, he was assassinated. That's not in case. But that show Kwara state not only to confusion, because katakata even in our party. Because there was nobody like Herman. There's somebody who would disarm him with a smile, even though he knows what he wants. It was so easy for him to get what he was, because it was everybody's friend, but within him, he knew the position he would take. But he will canvass his position in a way that you'll be forced to support that position, even if you are thinking that that was the kind of. So when he died, we never found out about it for how many years.
Somebody who died left a gap that would be too difficult to fill. It was by his death that I knew that what they were saying was really true. We found it difficult to have a replacement for him that will be like him on all fours. We couldn't have. Really,
we were together the day he was assassinated. I was with him in the morning. He gave an assignment that we should do this, do that. But he had a premonition, because on Thursday when we were together, he was not comfortable. We were asking him what is all. He said, "No, Kale, I will tell you later. Tell us, let us know what is going on." He said, "No, let me come back from Abuja. If I come back from Abuja, I will tell you what is happening to me." I told him, time is nobody's friends. Whatever you can do, do it now. He said, "No, no, no." And that was the last I heard of him. Not on the late evening, when a voice called me, a voice I was with on Thursday, that, "Kale, where is your friend?" I said, "He has traveled to Abuja. He'll be back on the Monday or Tuesday." He said he has been assassinated.
He survived by his mother, wife, 4 children and many siblings.
I thought it was not a dream, but I just didn't believe it at first. Because here, you know, we'd spoken just the night before. He was telling me that he's on his way back to Abuja the next day. So actually I was just busy in the house, you know, cleaning up, you know, just awaiting his arrival. He was coming in from lorry. And then my sister-in-law that came, her husband, who is the Senator Isa Mohammed, arrived. And then that's when the news, you know, they broke the news. My sister-in-law had come, you know, just to support, but they didn't tell me, they didn't break the news to me. It was her husband, the Senator Isa Mohammed, that came and broke the news. So, well, like every widow will tell you, it felt devastated. I didn't know what to do. I kept asking, where do I go? What am I going to do now? And that's it.
And I hate it. You know, whenever people talk about him, you can feel, or I feel, what they felt, you know, knowing a man like such as himself, that he was so great, very kind and loving and generous and just all good things. And I just think, like, wow, okay, I'm actually very proud to have a father who has left this kind of legacy behind. And alhamdulillah, you know, you say he was a great man, and just from the way you guys talk, honestly, it makes me so, so happy.
And that's a fact. I know that's a fact because of the stories that I've been hearing from people that are closest to him, even people that just come across him. They just tell me stories about how good of a person he was, and that makes me proud to say that that man, Amadou Sadana Ahmad Patigi, was my dad.
Sadana was called Hamad, or Na Amadou, by his closest friends, and Ya Sadana, or Uncle Sadana, by family. There was a uniqueness about him that endeared him to most who came around him. It goes without saying that he loved people, and the love was reciprocal. He tried to please where he could. He was humorous and was always looking on and for the bright side of life. He loved life. His habits in talk and actions set an example worthy of emulation. He was morally clean in mind and body. He was honest and respectful to everyone, especially to the needy, the aged, and children.
Sadana touched so many lives with his kindness, caring, loving, and peaceful nature. He is surely missed.
He was a man of great virtues. I've heard a lot about the great deeds he's done, how the kind of man he was to other people, how he's inspired other people to be the best version of themselves.
He was a giver and would gladly share what he had, even if it was little, with others. He would do so without expecting anything in return. Many would agree that Ahmad wants you to let anybody know what he had done for you. He was generous with his time, attention, and advice.
It is possible to say there is a human being that does not have enemies. We can say Ahmad Sadana doesn't have enemies because he tried his possible best to make people happy, to make sure he doesn't annoy anybody.
Those we love remain with us, for love itself lives on, and cherished memories never fade, even though a loved one is gone. Those we love can never be more than a thought apart, for as long as there is memory, they'll live on in our heart. Ya Sadana, as we fondly call him.
Fortunately, of course, this is our reality today. Ahmed is gone, but again, you know, the memories he left behind, you know, are still very outstanding. Ahmed, wherever you are, I know you are an angel. please continue to intercede for us, especially your dear wife and your children. May our good Lord continue to give your soul eternal rest.
One thing that I love about him is his spirit and love for his community, Patigi. No matter how late, even at 12 o'clock, Sadana will say he's going back to Patigi.
He loved children and was blessed with 4 biological ones and many of his nieces, nephews, cousins and friends. Children were considered his own. He has so much patience with them.
He loves kids a lot. He always will have kids around him, you know. His children were always around him. Suleyma, everywhere he goes, Suleyma will follow him. Sakina as well, you know. And, you know, like, you know, my other nephews, he was always around with kids, you know, everywhere he goes, yeah.
He did not seek for material things of life, but was ambitious to earn through honest means in order to meet his financial responsibilities, welfare, and happiness of his family and loved ones. Amadu Sadana Haman Patigi was a loving son, doting father, reliable friend, and good husband.
And the one that loses him the most in the family, because from childhood we grew up together. In fact, it was even a business proposal that he has for me. And he said I should wait. He will come back. You know, there is only 2 deaths that have pained me in my life. Even my heart was paining me. My then senior sister that had a motor accident and died, which was sudden too. And his own that was sudden. Even my own father's death doesn't pain me as my own brother's death. Amadu Sadana, I miss him a lot. I'm still missing him up to today.
As a friend, he has always been of service to us. All his friends, Sadana will always be interested in what you are doing and will always wish you well.
Nobody is perfect, but in near perfectness, very gentle. Ona Zumime is very charismatic. Everywhere you see him, he smiles. Smile is always on his face. We miss him, but I pray, just like I've said, may Allah grant him Aljanna Firdaus.
Just loved people. He was a people person. He cared about people. He just wanted to solve all your problems. He wanted everybody to be happy.
August 15th, 2002 was a day the family and many others will not forget. The shocking news of his death came as a big blow. The day before the horrific event, he had a lengthy discussion over the phone on various issues with his wife. Little did they know they were saying their final farewell. He was assassinated on his way to Abuja from Ilorin. His trip was to bring his family to Patigi and present his newborn son, Ahmed Baba, named after Baba Galadima, to his mother and other family members back home.
My kids were very young when it happened. The eldest was 7 years old. No. He would be the one that would remember his dad moment. At first, he wasn't really understanding what was going on until we came to Patigi when, just at the time of the burial, and he saw the dad's corpse being, you know, I mean, he didn't see that there was his dad, but he felt that was his dad. So it's like, that's my daddy. Yeah, so, yeah, everybody was sad. But eventually, as time passed, I accepted it. And alhamdulillah, God saw us through.
Amadu Sadana Aman Patigi might be gone, but he will never be forgotten. All that is left are nothing but memories. Memories that lead to silence and tears. But those that also leave comfort in knowing that in his short time on earth, he had touched many lives with his goodness. It is a bittersweet feeling that in death, people still talk of his good nature. Surely, it was the will of Allah that Amadu Sadana Aman Patigi should return to him when the applause was the loudest. Allahu Akbar.
Sadana left us too soon.
Sadona, rest in peace. Rest in peace.
So kweli uya miti mo.
May Amadou Sadana, Amampajiji, sweet and gentle soul, rest in peace, and his good legacies continue to live on. Amadou Sadana Amampatigi Foundation is inspired by the virtues of late Amadou Sadana Amampatigi, his socio-political virtues that further kindle and inspire a lot of people still living, even after many years of his passing on.
He is who I am today. And so I will always remember him as one who came in or came through life and sacrificed everything so that the world would change. Because as a result of him, I am able to develop myself to a point where my life mission, my purpose in life is to lift another so they can also live another, you know, lift another. It just, you know, looking back now, it amazes me how I found myself, you know, trading on the same lane.
He died in his prime. Immortalizing him by setting up a foundation would be a very, very good idea. Very good idea, really. One would have wished that this kind of idea germinated much, much earlier, maybe when he was alive, so that his father would have been immortalized.
I just want to thank my sister, Honorable Aisha Amampatigi, for thinking of this initiative. It's something, it's been in the pipeline for a while.
I captured in a memo in his honor titled Izagi, the woman of virtue, the journey of a political woman, an account by Honorable Aisha Amampatigi. It is a diction of a new world, New Nigeria Amampatigi, contained in the memo that will be launched soon with the mission of learning to create the circle of receiving by giving a great service in a great way for a greater reward. The goals are strictly human capital development to end the political violence and intimidations towards a unity of purpose, to create an enabling environment for people to utilize their full potentials through the mind, body, and soul, to ensure gender equity and strengthen women and girl child capabilities. Join us in the new world as we create abundance for all.